Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Christy Swanson.
Explained how to get into the business, and so I begged and begged and begged my parents. I think I was 9.
Wow.
And they didn't want to have anything to do. They were like, no, this seems weird. We don't know. They were just the kind of people that, like, you know, read the Inquirer in the grocery store, okay, believed every word it said. Yeah. You know, they just thought maybe Hollywood wouldn't be a good place for their child. I don't know.
Don't figure.
So they were very conservative. And so they, you know, I just begged, I just said, just all you have to do is take these pictures of me and send a letter to this agent and see what happens, you know. And so just to appease me, they did it, you know, and then the agency called and said, we would like to meet your daughter. And I went on my first interview with this agency, and I was so jazzed and excited and didn't really understand everything about showbiz or anything. I just wanted to do acting. And then they asked me to be a client and sent me out on my first audition the next day, and I got the job.
Wow.
Yeah.
Just like that.
Yeah. It was kind of
meant to be.
It was meant to be, I guess. Yeah. So 38 years later, still doing it. Yeah.
That's amazing. So of course you did a lot of work as a youngster, and then of course in your teens, that's when you got one of your first big breaks, which would have been, of course, Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's a small but pivotal role. Memorable, very memorable.
Yeah. That was really a lot of fun. I remember going to Paramount Studios and meeting John Hughes, and I auditioned for a part in the movie. I think it was a telephone call, and I got the part, you know, but I got a phone call from him while they were filming in Chicago, and he said, for, you know, like, location reasons, that scene that you're gonna shoot in the movie, I had to shoot it in Chicago, but I have good news, I've written you another part, and it's in the classroom, we're gonna shoot it at Paramount Studios. And I said, okay, he goes, we're gonna send you the dialogue over, and I said, all right. And I saw the dialogue, and I was like, oh my God, I gotta memorize this, and how am I gonna do that? And so we shot it, and it was a lot of fun. And he was crazy. He was such an awesome guy. I remember he was typing while we were shooting Ferris Bueller. He was typing and writing some kind of wonderful at the same time on this typewriter that doesn't even plug in. You know, what it was called. Yeah, exactly. So and then he said, oh, what are you doing this weekend? And I said, nothing. And he said, well, reshooting, he goes, I didn't direct it, but I wrote it. It's a movie called Pretty in Pink. And we shot it this last year, but we have to reshoot the end of the film. And I was wondering if you could be in it. And like, you end up with one of the main characters, Ducky, and like, you're gonna be Duckette. And I said, okay. So we actually had scenes, like there was dialogue and everything. John Cryer and I never got to shoot the actual scene because they took so long shooting all this stuff with Andrew and Molly, and so our scene got cut. So that's why we ended up just doing the wave high and get together. But it was a lot of fun. I liked working for John.
And I guess the same year you did Deadly Friend with Wes Craven, right?
Yeah,
that's
I did.
That's insane.
Wait.
Around the same time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because I shot that. It was the end of 85, and then we started Deadly Friend in January of 86, I believe.
Busy time.
Something like that. I don't know.
Thereabouts.
Yeah.
But that was obviously completely different. I mean, you were the star of that, so that was a huge jump.
Yeah. It was my first starring role in a feature film.
What was it like working with Wes?
Oh, amazing. Mm-hmm. I get choked up anytime somebody mentions his name.
No.
I just have a really warm place in my heart. He's just an amazing man, and I loved working with him.
It's a heck of a 1-2 punch going from John Hughes to Wes Craven as a professional. That's amazing.
Yeah, he's such a talent and just just a lovely, lovely man.
What was it like being the star of a major film like that? When you were shooting it, were you totally comfortable with that, or did it take some time to get used to?
Yeah, I mean, Wes took me under his wing. He really protected me and showed me through the ropes. I mean, I had been working, since 79, so I had experience on the set and everything and acting, but to have that responsibility, it was a big deal.
And you were ready.
I was ready, and I had just got my driver's license, and I could drive myself to work.
Learned how to throw a basketball at someone's head.
Yeah, that was fun.
It's fantastic. So, of course, a few years later, you can arguably your most iconic role is the original Buffy the Vampire Slayer. So, again, another starring role.
Yeah.
Big moment. And so tell us about getting into that.
Well, that was, I think I was 22 when we shot that. That was a lot of fun. I mean, the whole movie's fun. Everybody in it's fun. The dialogue's fun. It's a great story. It's campy. It's fun.
Did you get to meet Joss?
Oh, yeah. He was on the set.
Oh, he's on set?
Every single day. Yeah. I mean, he was a kid, too. I mean, we all were so young. And I remember him being on the set every single day, and it was really nice to have him there, because if a scene wasn't working right, for whatever reason, sometimes that happens when, dialogue's not working or we need to fix something, he was right there.
It's so rare to have a writer on set like that, if they're not directing, obviously.
Yeah.
And somebody's, it was so early in his career that he was so ready for that.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, the Paul Rubens scene, come on.
That
scene, that will live forever. It was so
like
beautiful.
The best scene in the movie. It really is.
How did you not lose it?
Well, I did. There were several takes.
Okay. Till it wasn't funny.
Yeah.
That never happened.
Like the first time we did it, I was like, what? And it was very hard to, if you watch it really closely, you can see me trying not to smile. Because I was killing me, but just to keep the straight face, it was very difficult.
Just watch him die.
Yeah, I'm just gonna ignore him. He's so funny. Yeah.
And so, and you've been working consistently even since that. I mean, it's pretty amazing. I was looking at your IMDb resume, and it's pretty solid right all the way through. Mm-hmm. So it must be nice to be able to consistently work like that.
Yeah, I consider myself blessed way, because in show business, Hollywood, whatever, it can chew you up and spit you out pretty easily. And so I'm grateful for the fact that I got to be a child actor, not a child star, because being a child star, you're always at risk of never having an adult career. Only very few make it that way, So to be able to have all this work and experience under my belt as a child was fantastic, and then transition into a young adult, an adult career, and then transition into now I play the mom all the time,
yeah.
Like Hallmark movies or Lifetime, and And I love it because I was a child actor, so when I work with kids that are, you know, playing my kids in the show, I love it because I know what they're going through and what they need, and I don't know, it's a great joy. I really like it.
And those are good work. I mean, it's easy to poop on the Hallmark films and the Lifetime films, but it's solid work. You know, it's good.
Yeah, no, it's good.
People love them. They have a strong audience, and they're consistent. Like I said, you've been working constantly over these last couple of years. It's fantastic. Do you find you're mostly shooting in Toronto?
I've shot a lot in Vancouver, mm-hmm. and then kind of all over. It all depends.
Yeah.
I just shot a Lifetime one in New Orleans last month, and you know, they're always just wherever the production is. You know. Mm-hmm.
Are they trying to get you a franchise?
So what do you mean?
Well, like just some kind of a recurring character, so you can get me a series of these Lifetime films instead of just one after another. Anything coming up?
Well, I have two Lifetime films coming up, but I am having a meeting with Hallmark in a few weeks. They want to sit and talk to me about something, and I don't know what it is.
I'll bet that's it.
I think there's a wheel of movies, like there's three in a row, or it's maybe a mini series. I'm not really sure.
The Lifetime Cinematic Universe.
Series
of connected films. Hallmark films.
Yeah,
they all come together in one giant film.
We'll see.
It wouldn't surprise me. Guys, if you want to start lining up at the microphone for any questions for Christy, that'll be great. Have you been doing a lot of conventions lately?
I've been doing like anywhere from like 2 to 3 a year.
Yeah. Just enough.
Yeah.
Get you out there.
Sometimes one, you know, it all depends on what's going on. But I like doing them because I love meeting all you guys and come up to the table and say, oh, I love that show, you know. I don't know, it just makes me feel good when I know I put a smile on someone's face or make them feel a certain way or make them laugh or whatever, you know.
Absolutely.
It's just pretty cool.
Don't be shy.
Don't be shy, I'm shy.
I'll bet. Go ahead.
How does it feel that you said...
What's your name?
I'm Scott.
Hi, Scott. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, how does it feel that you saved Batman so long ago?
Say that again?
That you saved Batman so long ago.
You saved Batman?
Ben Affleck was one of the people in Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Oh, yeah. Even I forgot that one.
Yeah, someone told me that he was in the movie, and I was like, really? He was?
So he was pretty forgettable at that stage.
I remember shooting that day, because I remember my parents were on set that day, because my dad played the referee, and my mom was an extra in the stands, but I don't remember meeting Ben, or, you know, I don't know.
But you saved so many people that day.
I saved Ben Affleck? That's so cool.
I see that.
That's funny.
Hi. I wanted to ask about your time on Psych. Are Marlo and Carlton still together, and are you going to be in the reunion movie?
the middle part I missed.
Are Margo and Carlton still together?
Oh, are they going to be in the movie?
Yeah, are you going to be in the movie? Are you guys still married on the show?
I haven't heard. I did hear they're going to make a movie. Comes out in Christmas time or something like that. I don't know if they've already shot it. I don't know if there's, I don't know anything, to be honest with you. I wish I did. I hope they ask me back. And my little baby.
Did you know when you did the first episode that you were going to be a recurring character?
I did not know. No, I just did one episode, and they just loved the chemistry between Carlton, right? Carlton?
Yeah.
Yeah, Carlton and I. And so they asked if I would do a couple a year. So I did, for 3 years, I did two episodes a year. So.
Well, it was great. You were good at it. You guys did have very good chemistry.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun, that show. I just loved doing that show. What a great group of people. Like, amazing. Yeah. I hope I'm in the...
That would be disappointing.
got turned off your microphone. Maybe, is there a button on it, or?
Hello?
Okay.
So I was going to ask about Buffy, and then I went on IMDb before this panel, and I saw your Ferris Bueller's Day Off, and I was like, I love Ferris Bueller's Day Off. And I didn't realize you were the girl who had the insane
Simone.
Simone, who has the insane line. How did you remember, like, how did that, how were you able to do that? Because, like, I tried to do it once, and it's...
He's sick. See, my best friend's sister's boyfriend's brother's girlfriend heard from this kid who was this girl who... My best friend's sister's boyfriend's brother's girlfriend heard from this guy who knows this kid who's going out with a girl who saw Paris pass out at 31 Flavors last night. I think it's pretty serious. No problem whatsoever.
What is 31 Flavors? Maybe I'm too young.
Are you lactose intolerant? Maybe that's why your parents never wanted you to be exposed
well,
to it.
She's so young.
It's sure.
I'm 20, I'm sorry.
It's nice to meet you.
She's like, I know what Cold Stone is.
there's some Baskin Robbins still around.
Oh yeah, we've got lots of, where I live in Valencia, there's a bunch of, it's like an ice cream shop.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then about Buffy, so I started watching a TV show because a friend loves it, and I was at a comic book shop, and I was talking to somebody who's older than I am, and they're like, oh no, I will never watch a TV show because I love the movie, she's Buffy, and I'm like, wait, there's a movie?
That's funny.
So, like, do you ever get, like, people being like, oh, like, I like the TV show, or have you ever seen the show? Like, do you, what do you think of, like, the other Buffy?
The other Buffy, or the TV series? Well, what I think of it is, I think it's great. I did not watch it. I was not, you know, like an avid watcher of the show. I watched the very first episode, which I think was a movie or a movie of the week. It was like a really like 2-hour pilot, something like that. And I saw some of that, but I didn't, you know, a lot of people ask me, why didn't you play the part? And it was 7 years after the movie had been released, so I would have been almost 30 when that came out. So they didn't use anybody from the movie in the series, and but it, a lot of people wonder if I was upset by that, and I never was, because I thought, I just think it's so awesome that young girls get to watch this awesome character every week on TV. That's, you know, that's the best. So I think it's great, and you know, I'm glad it was so successful, and everybody has their thing, you know, they like the original, or they like the new one, or, you know, everybody has their own feelings or opinions and however it, you know, hits them emotionally. So, you know, it's, you know, if they like the original, then I'm like, yeah.
The show would be there without the movie.
And now I've watched the movie, so I've actually seen it now, and I know
it. Yeah. But they should like both, because, I mean, Joss wrote both.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Hi. I was curious, out of all the movies you've filmed, which one holds a special place in your heart and why?
Gosh, it's hard to say.
So many.
I've never heard that question. I get, what's your favorite? But that this is a different question, so I'm trying to answer it intelligently. Good luck with that. let's see. I don't know. You know, I like them all for different reasons, you know? Like, 8 Heads in a Duffel Bag. Didn't turn out as well as you read it, you know, like it wasn't as, I don't know, it wasn't like super successful, but I had the best time making that movie because the cast, like I literally was in stitches laughing every day, every second of every day. So that was a lot of fun. The Phantom was a lot of fun and I loved it, and it's a great memory for me because we got to go to Thailand and in the jungle and Australia, and it was an adventure. But then, you know, there's certain movies that I like A Christmas Wish that I did. I like that, you know, simple indie film that, you know, it just turned out nice, you know, it's like a nice family movie. So I can't say that I have, I don't know, they all have a special place in my heart. Yeah.
One last question, because you're very you know, I love your acting mm-hmm. skills. I was curious, are you a method actor? What type of actress are you? Because you're really a great actress.
Oh, thank you so much. I don't consider myself a method actress at all, because I've worked with some method actors, mm-hmm. and I definitely can see a difference. I don't know. What I do is I just create a backstory for my character that's not even there in the script, just so that I have some emotional stuff going on underneath. I don't know. I just try to. I don't know how to explain it. Jeez.
It just comes naturally.
I don't know how to explain it. But thank you. It's a really nice compliment. I really appreciate it.
I just wanted to ask you real quick, what I forgot about, which was, I really loved it, was The Chase with Charlie Sheen. That was, I saw that in the theater when it came out. I thought it was incredible, and it broke my heart that it didn't make $100 million. So I just thought it was just such an intense thrill ride. I mean, that must have been a really crazy shoot. Just the nature of it all. Most of it was in the car, of course. So.
Yeah, I was grateful to be in the car with Charlie. He's a funny guy. Like, he's probably one of the funniest guys that I've ever met. Just witty, you know, and crazy, funny stuff he says. And we were shooting in Houston in July.
Oh, God.
So we're being pulled by a camera truck. In the Beamer, and we're on like an insert vehicle thing. And so we were in the car all cool with the AC on, and the whole crew is out in the trucks.
Dying.
Yeah, dying, drinking water. It felt so bad for them. But I had a really good time on that one. That was fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was just so entertaining. It was just
baffling. Yeah, it had a lot of good energy to it.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And Henry Rollins is awesome.
Oh, Hank was so good.
Yeah.
As a cop. I mean, come on, that was so beautiful. Yeah. Henry Rollins as a cop. Yeah. He just relished that.
And yeah. he always helped me learn my lines. He would always
really?
Yeah, be like, I need to rehearse this scene a little bit more before we shoot. Can you run lines with me? Sure, yeah. He'd love doing that.
It's intense.
Yeah.
Hi.
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 Jenny.
Hi, Jenny.
How are you? Nice to meet you. I was just wondering, what is it like having the experience of being somewhat of a feminist icon? Like, it's hard to watch Buffy or anything like that without walking away feeling empowered, so I can't imagine how empowering it must be to embody that. So I was just wondering how that is and if you have had experiences with fans even about that.
With fans?
With fans telling you, you know, how empowered they feel watching your work or that they can view as a feminist icon.
I have met a lot of fans female fans that have come up to me and you have no idea what that movie did for me for, you know, whatever was going on in their life when they were a young girl and how it empowered them. I've heard that a lot, actually. And I can't take credit for that. I mean, Joss wrote the character, so that's really, you know, that's, you know, more his thing, but I mean, I just made it come to life, but it's, you know, it's definitely something that a lot of women really, you know, they just think, she's just an ordinary girl that, you know, she's tough though, you know, she's strong.
Does it feel like an added responsibility for you?
An added responsibility?
To be a feminist icon for people?
I don't know, I never thought of it that way. I never thought of it that way.
It just comes naturally.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you, Jenny.
Hi, I just have a fun little question.
Okay.
So obviously you, sorry, Sean.
Yeah.
I do it all the time. So obviously you've been a part of these great movies that we all love, like Buffy and The Chase. What is a movie that speaks to you? Not that you've done, to just you're like, that's my movie. Like, this resonates so well with me.
Just a personal favorite film.
Yeah.
Oh, a favorite film
mm-hmm.
that I would identify with?
Or just something that speaks to you.
Or speaks to me. I don't know. Oh, goodness.
Do
I don't watch a lot of movies, to
really?
Be honest with you. Yeah, that's the truth. But I don't really go. Like, I have a 10-year-old, so I'll see a lot of, like, kids' stuff that's out. But I haven't, I haven't really seen anything recently.
What about growing up? Did any performance kick your butt? And part of the reason why you wanted to get into acting, maybe some actor or actress?
Well, I grew up, you know, like I loved watching Elizabeth Montgomery on Bewitched and Lucy. She was a favorite, you know. I just loved them. And then actors, like I liked Jack Lemmon.
Sure.
You know, I mean, I don't know. I wish I could answer that. I wish I could. I'm sorry.
Oh, no. No, that's okay. Right.
Yeah.
Just a fun question.
If something comes to my mind, then I'll let you know.
So what other passions do you have at home when you're not acting and you've got some downtime? What do you like to do?
I'm a full-time mom. I have a 10-year-old. I'm a hockey mom.
Oh, hockey mom.
Yeah, so I get to play with things. Go, Mac Dog! You know, I love that. That's fun.
That's the best.
And, so I do that, take him to rock climbing. I love being a mom, that's like the best thing. And so I do that, and then I love golf.
Golf?
I like golfing, and my husband and I ride motorcycles.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Touring bikes, or?
Yeah, well, we just went on a trip up from like LA up to Monterey, California coast. And it was gorgeous.
That's bad.
Yeah, it was fun. It was for charity for pediatric brain cancer.
What were you riding?
I was riding an Indian Scout.
Nice.
Yeah. And my husband has a Harley.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
Proper.
Yeah.
No going for your hockey.
It's all up here. Yeah,
the hangers.
So.
Hangers, that's right. Yeah. That's a fun visual.
So I have a movie in development called Journey, which is about a woman that is a bike builder, and hoping to get that made. We're like three quarters of the way there on our budget. So
yeah. That's a fun area. Getting that. We're so close.
I'm not producing it. My friends are producing it, but it would be myself and Jet Jurgensmeyer. I don't know if you know. But yes, he's in the new Babysitter movie. He's a really good actor. I love him. He's awesome. So.
Do you hang out with a lot of actors in your free time? Just as contemporaries?
No. I mean, I have a lot of friends that are actors that we keep in touch and stuff like that. But my main group of people that I hang with all the time are...
Just bombs?
Yeah, kind of.
Friends.
Or, well, one of my best friends is Heather Burton. She was my stunt double for many years. She was like one of the highest paid stunt women at one time. She wing walk on planes and horse stuff. And she's one of my best friends, so, which, you know, she's a stunt woman. So she's in the business.
It's such an interesting relationship. And I hear about that a lot where well-known actors are really best friends with their stunt doubles. Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, it's a little odd.
Yeah.
Being with somebody physically similar to you, but I, you know, obviously you have to bond in that environment too.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah. She's awesome. Yeah. We have a lot of fun together.
What are you working on next?
Next? I have the Crowning Jewels is coming out this summer, I believe. We're doing a premiere in Indiana in July. And then...
What's Crowning Jewels?
It's like a teen movie, and I play the villain.
Ooh.
And it's the comedy, you know. And then I did the Parents' Worst Nightmare, Mother's Sacrifice, and then Bad Stepmother.
Bad Stepmother?
Yeah.
Are you the Bad Stepmother?
Yeah.
That's gotta be funny, playing the villain.
It's originally called Wicked Stepmother, which I prefer that title. I like Wicked Stepmother.
The Disney folks have a little chat about that.
But then Lifetime was called Bad Stepmother, and I go, but then it sounds like a comedy.
It doesn't sound classy.
I don't know.
Wicked Stepmother sounds classy.
Yeah, but there's this new thing where they want their titles to be closer to A, because when it comes up in searches, so that's why they want
it. It's sad but true. It's so effective.
Well, then call it A Wicked Stepmother.
A. Aronson.
Never take my advice.
That That's why those mockbusters always put a date in front of the name of the movie, because it's an easy cheat to get to the top of the queue.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Call it Atrocious Stepmother.
There you go.
Atrocious Stepmother.
Atrocious Stepmother. Coming that would work too. I'm gonna put that in the hat.
Well, Chrissy's got a photo op coming up later on. I believe around 5:30. If anybody wants to get in on that.
Everybody brush your hair, put on your lipstick.
Yeah, look good. She's also, of course, got her booth on the floor, so please come by and say hello. Get a nice 8x10 sign. But anyway, Chrissy, thank you very much. Give it up for Chrissy Swanson.
This video is sponsored by the Crazy Kings of Toys. Check them out for all your toy needs and find out why they are so crazy. Find them at eBay, BrickLink, and Facebook. Links are in the description. For more Toxic Pop, visit our website at toxicpop1.wixsite.com/toxicpop. Email us at toxicpop1@gmail.com and check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/toxicpop1 and Instagram at instagram.com/wearetoxicpop. Links are in the description.